Very good morning class, myself Pallavi Anand and I welcome you in the session of Science Standard 4. In this very session we will learn about the earth and its neighbors. So we will learn how earth is revolving, what is the earth structure of earth, about sun and different type of heavenly bodies. As you know that earth is also the eighth planet which is revolving or orbiting around the sun. It is different from the other planet because earth is only the planet which have life on it, and sun is a star, you can say, without which the life on earth is not possible actually. Okay, so we will get to know that it was many heavenly bodies nearby, and one by one we should learn about them. So as you know that sun is in the center of the solar system. You can see the picture over your screen here. This is the sun. It is a hot ball of gases. You can say ball of fire as well. Sun is a ball of fire, and these are the orbits on which the different heavenly body rotating or orbiting the sun. They revolve around the sun on their fixed orbit, on their fixed path. You can see Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Nowadays Pluto is not, Pluto is extinct nowadays. So you can see all these eight planets revolving on its own axis. You see, Mercury will revolve in on its own axis. Venus will revolve in on its own axis. Earth is revolving around the sun on its own orbit. Then Mars will rotate on this own orbit, revolve around the sun. Then you can see Jupiter. Jupiter is the biggest planet and it is revolving around the sun on its own individual. You can see here, this is the orbit of Jupiter. It will just revolve on its own orbit. Okay. Next is Saturn. Saturn will also just go on revolving around the sun on its own axis. It will not go here and there, or it will not jump its axis and come on the orbit of Jupiter. So Saturn will just revolve around its own axis without interacting or interfering the other orbit. They are having their own fixed orbit, or you can say orbiting, through which they orbiting or revolving around the sun. Next one is Uranus, then Neptune. They all are having its own characteristic features and they are just revolving around the sun. Sun is in the center, sun lies in the center of the solar system. This is the solar system. And sun lies, you can see here, the sun, and it is lying on the center of the solar system. Now, the next is the earth. We will learn about earth, its structure of the earth, and come, let's start one by one, we will solve out. So, about sun we will learn. Sun is a hot ball of gases. We can say sun is a hot ball of gases. Sun lies in the center of our solar system. Sun appears so very large because it is situated about 150 million kilometers away from the earth. So distance between the earth and the sun is about 150 million kilometers. How much? 150 million kilometers. Okay. So distance between the earth and sun is about 115 million kilometers. Sun is the nearest star. It seems a very huge ball type shape, and you can see it with open eyes, you can find out. But you cannot see the stars, because stars are situated far further from the sun. Stars are situated very far from the sun. So they are not visible so large. they are visible as sparkling only. Something is sparkle. We cannot identify the real structure of star, okay? But we can identify the structure of sun because it is the nearest star. So we can identify the shape, of the star, and we can also feel the heat and light provided by the sun. Can we find the light provided by the stars? We cannot find the light provided by the star because it was a very, 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 very far from the earth. Okay, now you now know the exact, no, not exact, but you can say the approx distance between the earth and the sun is 150 billion kilometers. Okay, now sun, as we are saying, as you have heard here, hot ball. Sun is the hot ball, means it is a ball of fire. Can you just imagine the temperature on the sun? The temperature of the sun is about 6000 degrees Celsius. Okay, 6000 degrees Celsius. The temperature of the sun is 6000 degrees Celsius. Sun is the ultimate source of energy. Sun provides us heat. Sun provides us light. We cannot imagine our life without sun. So the life is not at all possible on the earth without the appearance of sun. Suppose there is a cloudy weather and due to very cold we cannot find sun, or due to the cloud we cannot find sun 2 or 3 days. Just imagine what is happening. We cannot use to dry our clothes. It is very problem to dry our clothes. It's very, you can find somewhere smelly, and number of germs also increases due to the absence of sunlight. In this sunlight there are lots many rays are there who help us to kill the germs. They just avoid the germs. They provide us heat, they provide us light, and in nutshell you can say sun is the view source of, ultimate source of energy. Okay, next we will learn about the earth. So now after the sun we will learn the earth. Okay, earth is a very beautiful blue planet because it is surrounded by the water all the three sides, and we can say earth is a blue planet and it's look very beautiful from the outer body, solar bodies, when it is being picturized by the moon and by the other places. It is seems very beautiful planet, and earth is only the planet which have life upon it, and it is a land. It has land, water, mountain and plains. Earth has life because it has land, it has water, it has mountain, it has plains, trees, grasses, fruits, veggies, many, so many natural things God has gifted to the planet earth. And due to that very gifts, earth life is possible on the earth. Earth was first born as a huge ball of dust and hot gases. Earth was born as a ball of hot dust and hot gases. As different planet, earth is also was born as a ball of dust and ball of gases. And earth was spinning all the time. What earth is doing? Earth was spinning around the sun. As it was the sun, and earth was revolving and revolving and revolving continuously towards, on its own axis towards the sun. Okay, this one is sun, and earth was continuously just spinning towards the axis around the sun. Due to it, this spinning, due to the this spinning, some of the gases present in the earth escaped from it, and some of the gases are being trapped inside the earth. Due to this various spinning, continuous spinning, the gases which are present in the earth get escaped, and some of the gases are stored in the earth. Okay, next is the first time we got a complete view of earth was in 1968. In 1968 we got a clear picturization of Earth. It was the picture taken from the moon. The picture was taken from, not from the moon, the picture was taken when Apollo 8 astronaut flew around the moon. Okay, where it is flowing? Flowing around the moon and saw the Earth. When the Apollo 8 astronaut flew around the moon, from there he looked towards the Earth and he have the clear configuration of Earth. And it was taken, the clear configuration was given in 1968. Next we will learn the structure of Earth surface. Okay, so now we will learn about the structure of Earth. As Earth, you can see here, it is our Earth, and Earth is a very beautiful and blue planet, as I said. Now, Earth is also having several different layers. Okay, the upper layer of the Earth is very hard and hot. The upper layer of the Earth, which is made up of a thin layer of, you can say the upper layer, which is known as crust. The upper layer, you can see, this is the upper layer of the Earth and this is known as crust. It is made up of solid rocks. Upper layer of the Earth is made up of solid rocks and it is known as crust. The central layer, the middle layer of the Earth, is made up of hot rock. Made up of hot rocks and it is known as mantle. The middle part of the Earth, with the middle layer of the Earth, is made up of hot rocks, or it is also sometime available in a liquid form. You have seen the volcanic eruption. Volcanic eruption is, you can see, this is how volcanic eruption occurs. In the volcanic eruption, the liquid rock melts and come out from the, oozes out from the cracks. And this is known as volcano, and it is appear in the mountains, earth crust, and the liquid layer of the Earth is known as hot liquid layer, and it is available in a mantle portion. And the middle part of the Earth, the center part of the Earth, is known as core. There are two types of core, inner core and outer core. What are the two types of cores? The inner core and the outer core. The inner core is solid and the outer core is liquid. The two types of core available in the center part of the Earth, that is inner core and outer core. Inner core is known as, the inner core is known as the solid form and the outer core is liquid form. Now, in the mantle area, in the mantle part, in the middle of the Earth crust, it is made up of hot rocks, okay? And when these hot rocks oozes out or come out from the cracks, it's known as volcano. This is known as volcano. You have seen the many type of volcanic eruption, from where the hot rock or lava, hot molten rock is known as, you can see, hot molten rock is known as lava. When it is come out from the earth crust, from the cracks, and it is known as lava. Okay, suppose you have learned up to here what is sun, what are the earth, and what is the structure of the earth. In the next video, we will continue with our next topic. Till then, bye bye, take care.